and you can watch whatever you want. But it's not on Netflix.com.
Wade Rollinson.
It's all there.
Who?
And by there, I mean not on Netflix.com. So check it out. Yep, gonna say it one more time. Not on Netflix.com.
Rollinson.
Get Tubi in your lives today.
This is John Rollinson. The Orlando Magic.
Yeah,
listen to Magic Talk all day long.
I don't even know.
Just say, Alexa, play 96.9 The Game on radio.
The following is a paid program. The views and opinions expressed in this program are not those of iHeartMedia, its management, or advertisers. Welcome to the WSA WorldSportsAlumni.com Hour with the Brandon Merriweather Show. From the Miami Hurricanes to the NFL Pro Bowl, for the Patriots, Redskins, Giants, Brandon has seen and done it all. With his realist co-host, Tori Lewis, giving it to you straight on sports and life on Orlando's sports leader, 96.9 The Game, presented by SaveOnYourHomes.com.
What's up? What's up? What's up? Yo! Yeah, y'all know who it is, man. It's your boy, Brandon Merriweather, back in the building.
Yes, sir.
With Control Chaos, and y'all know I got my guy with me. The realest, illest, stupidest co-host in America. My guy.
Right. You throw the stupid. You back to sneak this in. You throw
that I ain't sneak this in this morning.
Yeah, you back to sneak this. My stupidest coat.
You know, good morning, everybody. Good morning.
Good morning to all the great listeners.
Listen, man.
There.
Listen, we got some things to talk about today, man.
Absolutely, dude. We got a lot to touch on.
But you know what I want to ask you though.
What's that?
Do you watch any baseball?
Yes, I do. Big Yankee fan.
Now, you know what I realized? You try to be a fan of all the heavy hitters.
Well, you know, once again.
Bro, hold on. You're a fan of the Lakers?
Absolutely.
You're a fan of the Yankees?
Mm-hmm.
Who your football team?
Cleveland Browns.
Oh, that's the only underdog What I'm saying is,
I'm listening.
Like all the teams with the big money, you're a fan of?
Oh, not necessarily.
Only the Cleveland.
My Lakers ain't won in a while. My Yankees haven't won in a while.
Yeah, but they got the big money though.
Yeah, but it doesn't translate to us winning. You gotta have players.
The Lakers always considered, they always, you know.
But we're not winning, though.
When last time you won, like 5 years ago, 6 years ago?
Are you serious right now? Are you joking? Much longer than that.
When was Kobe last?
His last ring was 2011.
Oh, okay, 9 years
last
ago.
Last ring was against the Boston Celtics.
Nah, it couldn't be.
We beat Boston, then we beat the Magic. Those were the last 2 rings we got against the Magic in Boston. Boston beat us the first time.
Yeah, you absolutely
come
right.
Back, beat Boston, you're then
right.
Beat the
then
Magic.
Beat the Magic. Yeah, the Magic should have won that.
Really?
Absolutely.
Back to our scheduled program.
The reason the Magic didn't win that.
You sound like a UCF fan now.
The reason the Magic didn't win that is because they played Jamil Nelson over Skip Timalu.
How many games you got to play to win the finals? 4.
Yeah. Hey, but what?
So stop it. Stop.
What I'm saying is. The Magic was up in the series. Do you not remember that? The Magic.
You're saying up like he was up 3-1 or something. You was one game?
Yeah, they was up 3-2. What are you talking about? That was a 7-game series. The Magic was up 3-2.
That game did not go 7 games. That series did not go 7 games.
Oh, my God. All right, brother. See, like I said.
There you go with the foolishness.
Like I said.
That did not go 7 games.
Yes, it did.
No, it did not.
Yes, it did.
Four Rivers.
Bro, you already owe me Four Rivers.
We broke even.
Bro, you ain't paid yet.
I won the first bet.
You know what? I'm sick and tired of this.
You won the second bet.
Hey, get your hands off me.
I won the first bet. You won the second bet.
Get your hands off me. Hey, y'all, listen.
You be bucking anyway.
Hey, listen, man.
Listen.
I'm sick and tired of this.
I'm telling you. They be bucking on the bets. I'm telling you.
You know what I mean? Hey, so listen, right?
What's up?
How you feel about the... Astros, what they did.
The Astros, okay, first of all, let's start from the beginning. Understand this, that baseball has been stealing signs from little league to the professional level for the last 80 years, okay? But what the difference, and so you get most people arguing one point saying, well, we've been stealing signs. Because they do. They look at the second baseman, looks over at the third base coach, and they do. And he looks back at the catcher, which they do. But what the Astros did that's different from the stealing of signs is they actually recorded. They actually had videos that they were recording the signs. So that took it to a whole nother level. It's one thing, if you got a good memory and you can remember what the guy did, two up, two down, three left, and you can remember that means a curve or a fastball or a breaking ball, that's great for your mind. But they took it to another level by video. And that's why the outrage. So me personally, I do believe they should take it from them. They should. And I'm going to tell you what. You ask my opinion. They had one of the guys was wearing a buzzer. The one that hit the home, the game winning home run, he had on a buzzer. That's why when he ran, he told him, don't snatch off my jersey, don't throw no water on me. And he ran straight to the dugout, to the locker room, and then came back out after he took the buzzer off. Now, Major League Baseball seen him when he ran, when he hit the game winning home run, and he ran in the tunnel. But then they don't have any video from there. So, again, then yesterday, right. Big Poppy calls it. Then yesterday, Big Poppy of the Boston Red Sox, he called.
Yeah, that's the homie, man. Right? That's the homie.
Big Poppy calls the guy that told on everybody, the pitcher. He calls him a snitch. Tell me, why you out here snitching and why you out? So, again, everybody knows they did wrong. And all I'm saying is, I'm not saying give it. Because if you look at their games, they wasn't blown nobody out. All their games were going seven games. All right.
So this is how I look at it, right?
How you look at it?
This is how I look at it.
How you look at it?
I see you got your Alabama stuff out there.
I'm feeling real excited about Tuscaloosa right now.
Before
Charlie Strong and Tuscaloosa.
Yeah, I've seen it.
I'm real excited what we're doing down there.
Right? All right, so.
But anyway, go ahead.
So before I get on the Astros and this baseball. You know what
Astros,
I mean? Astros, all the same.
You're sounding like
All the same.
You sound like the guy that rap.
All the same. But listen,
you sound like the guy Scott.
All right, yeah. So when you call me Mayweather, I'm gonna check that too.
Mayweather.
See what I mean?
That's a compliment.
No, it ain't a compliment.
Got it. No, Mayweather. Okay, all
right,
go ahead.
So listen, right? Before I get on that, I want to shout out them Canes. Huh? Baseball team, the number one team in the nation right now.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Shout out them Canes. We playing the number two team in Florida today.
Okay.
Oh, actually, I think game one was yesterday. Oh,
how are you guys number one? Okay. How'd that happen? What does that mean?
Also, in local.
Where my buddy?
The local Hoopers.
What's
shout out
buddy?
To Windermere High School boys who's going to the next round of the region. And shout out to them Jones High Tigers once again. Not only are we showing we can tote that rock, but we can pat that pill. Going to the next round of the regionals, one game from state. Jones High boys basketball team.
That's what's up.
And Windermere boys basketball team.
All right, so let me get on this right.
Okay, go ahead.
I think this is how I look at it, right? I don't think they should take the trophy from them.
I'm not surprised. You saying that? I'm not surprised. And I'm gonna tell you why. Go ahead.
Cut it out. Yeah. Cut it out.
You have a history, but go ahead.
Cut it out.
You have a history, so I understand your point.
Bro, you gonna let me talk?
Yes.
Golly. Listen, I don't think they should take it. And okay. This is why I don't think they should take it. Because, for one, everybody done cheated and won. Everybody. Every team that ever won one have cheated to win one in baseball. So I feel like if you take it from them, then you got to take it from the Yankees. You got to take them from the Red Sox. You got to take them from Houston. Because all of them cheated. You know what I mean? Everybody who won during the steroid era, you got to take it from.
Well, like, during the steroid era, none of the guys that was hitting home runs from here to China was even in the playoffs, was even winning.
What are you talking about? The last World Series that the Yankees won, A-Rod was on steroids. What are you talking about?
A-Rod?
A-Rod got caught right after they won the World Series, bro. What are you talking about?
So you mean to tell me?
Yes. A-Rod got caught right after they won this World Series. Look it up. I did my research on this one. Because that was my whole point. So if you're going to take it from them.
But we're not talking about steroids.
Hold on. Just listen to me.
At that time, steroids illegal?
Right. Yes. Steroids still illegal. What are you talking about? Yes, steroids have always been illegal in sports, in all sports. So, yes.
But baseball turned a blind eye to everybody on steroids.
Bro, you hear this?
Baseball turned a blind eye around steroids. But
but what I'm saying, this is what I'm saying.
Okay.
So if you gonna punish them, and now granted, do I think they need a punishment?
I don't care what the crime is.
Because how much you wanna bet, if you ask 90%, if you ask everybody in baseball, right? How much you wanna bet? Let's say retired. Because the people right now ain't gonna tell on themselves.
Okay.
So if you ask every retired team, every retired player, and say, did y'all ever record? Every one of them will say, yeah, we did.
No. I ain't gonna believe that. I'm not gonna believe that. No.
So, hold on, listen to me. When I start hitting home runs out the park, he always try to jump in.
And I was to make a point.
I done made several points.
Okay, let me know when you're done making your point.
But listen.
Because your background is flawed.
Why you think all these old-time players coming up and saying, man, why you snitching? Why y'all telling them? Like, why you think all of them doing it? They ain't doing that because they more compass saying, hey, man, y'all don't tell nobody. They doing that because they saying, man, everybody did it. Like, you done seen other players come out and say, man, listen, everybody do that.
Not the video, though.
Man, what everybody records signs. Everybody do. Everybody.
I need you to show me that.
Everybody do that. Because what they don't do is they don't have little speakers and microphones saying, oh, it's finna be a curve. It's gonna be a fastball. They don't do that now, but they do.
Everybody has admitted that the Houston Astros went to a whole nother level.
Absolutely, that's why I said
they went beyond just
peekaboo. Did I not just say that? I just said that.
So
I said the only thing that Houston did that everybody don't do is had a little microphones on it. They put the little microphone like, yo, this gonna be a curveball. Like, yo, this finna be a, you know, like, get ready for this fastball. Right down the middle. Bam! See, okay. In other words, I think they're, if you take it from them, mm-hmm. after everything they did,
right,
you have to take it from everybody.
Okay.
Like, and I'm a Red Sox fan, you know.
Right, and they're going to be punished also because they have been found out as well. Just last year they was doing so. I'm not surprised.
Look at this.
But
look at this.
To give the listeners, boy, you know what?
Boy, this
to give you listeners boy, a, little you back, see this? A little background on Brandon Merriweather is Brandon Merriweather played for the New England Patriots. This is your
key. So okay, everybody knew that.
Some of you, my listeners, didn't know that.
So everybody knows that.
Let me give you a little preview information on him. That team has been punished by the NFL on two occasions for videoing.
Yeah.
When they played the St. Louis Rams, they videoed the St. Louis Rams practices, which they inevitably beat the St. Louis. They ended up beating the St. Louis Rams in the Super Bowl.
Or
they were just this past season was caught again using video, sent video guys to the Cincinnati Bengals game. So again, I understand why Brandon would be saying they shouldn't be punished because he played for an organization who is notoriously known for doing things like this. And that is the New England Patriots. Spygate.
This is my question.
And ain't nobody doing that but y'all.
This is my question. Oh, that's what you believe?
Yes.
Let's not understand. I played for four different organizations and you really believe that?
The Redskins ain't sent nobody out. Redskins didn't send nobody out videoing nobody. The Giants didn't send nobody out videoing nobody.
That's what you believe?
Absolutely.
You funny.
You'll be the first to say they did.
I ain't saying nobody did nothing because I ain't no snitch.
Okay.
what I'm saying is, hey, you watch baseball?
No, I heard about all this stuff, though. I mean, I feel like anybody could, like, study signs and stuff. But the they microphones?
Were and videoing.
Video. Maybe a little much, but I mean, anybody can do that. Microphones, that's something else.
Listen,
that's a little much.
Listen,
they had on the ESPN.
Hold on, check
that. They had a sign where they hit the trash can twice. This was crazy what they was doing.
That thing worked though. That's all.
That's just more than cheap.
When things work, man, you
y'all
gotta be
it down for whatever. Y'all hear that? Listeners, he's down for whatever.
Listen, when you winning, mm-hmm. everybody gunning at your buddy. So, but what I'm saying though, seriously though, if you gonna punish one,
okay,
you gotta punish all.
Well, my thing is, okay, well, we can't get you for what we don't know. Let's move him forward. We're going to do Houston Astros and four.
You know, A-Rod was going to stay Rubs. You knew that. He got caught right after the season.
Did you hear what I just said?
You can prove that.
Did you hear what I just said?
So that means you got to take it. Make sure you say take it from them, too.
Moving forward, we're doing 2019.
No.
The last champion.
No.
Moving forward.
No. Because if you doing the last champion, that's going in the past. That's in the past. So if you're going to do the last champion and move forward, no, bro, you can't do that.
What are they going to do? They got no strip of title, but
they not
already.
Listen, do I think they need to be punished? Yes.
You guys fired your manager for cheating.
Absolutely.
Right. So you okay then?
But you heard what he said. The only reason we fight him because it hit the media. If it wouldn't hit the media, then we wouldn't fight him. I promise. Okay. Listen, you win, buddy.
I see where you at.
Win
by any means. I see where
by
you
any
at.
Means. I don't care how you want to look at it. Win.
I see where you at.
You know what I mean, cause you gotta think about it, bro. You gotta think about it. It's hard to win in the majors.
Yeah, but
yeah, sure. Hey man, hey, your mic on. Hey, turn your mic off. Yeah.
But again,
what's up?
Turn your mic off.
But again, I understand, you know, them going about it trying to win the best, you know, win by any means, but when we doing videos and we doing
I want you to answer one question for me.
Equipment on us as we going to another level.
I want you to answer one question.
Buzzers on us? No.
Let me ask you one question. You don't think Alabama cheat?
No. They don't have to.
You don't think Georgia cheat? You don't think LSU cheat?
What is your definition of what do you mean they're cheating? What is your definition of cheat? Make it plain. What are you saying by saying do I think Alabama cheat? Come on, give me something. Give me something better than just a generalized statement saying, "Do I think
doing something
doing like what?
Doing something that they shouldn't be doing, like paying recruits that come to Alabama.
I don't have any proof.
No.
I didn't say that.
That is not what I asked you. I never said, do you know for sure? I said, you don't think they are.
I don't think they are. What? I don't. I do not think Alabama paying their players. No, I don't.
Let me ask you a question, and I want you to be honest with me.
I just answered the question.
I'm just telling you. I want you to be honest with me.
Do you think Miami playing their players right now? You think the Hurricanes are paying their players?
No, I think that's why we at. I think that's why we at where we at. I'm being honest.
Okay.
I think that's why we where we
so
at.
So you said y'all got a great program. Y'all ain't paying no play. Y'all ain't doing nothing illegal. That's why you say that's the
yeah,
problem.
And that's why we 7-6. That's why we 7-5.
That's
that was,
cute.
You know what I mean?
That's
but,
cute.
But listen.
Go ahead.
So you telling me that
mm-hmm.
you think somebody would want to go to boring
Tuscaloosa, Alabama?
Yeah.
Right.
Over the beautiful city of Miami?
Because I'm playing to
go
to the NFL.
Just listen to me.
I'm not playing to go to club KODs. I'm not playing to go to club one. I'm not going to Miami to go to Edgar and James club one. I'm not going down there. But I'm going to try to play 3 years and be eligible to play in the NFL. That's where I'm going.
I get
back to club one on the back end. But I'm going down here to get this, bag by.
Bro, you go to FAMU. You go to FAMU. You ain't do that.
And do what?
And go to the NFL. You go to FAMU. You ain't do that.
But why they ain't going?
Cause you
FAMU is not a football factory.
Mathis went to BCC.
Okay, and how long has it been since then?
Rogers Cromartie went to
Tennessee State. Right.
So you could go anywhere.
Right.
But
right.
Hey, y'all, we gotta take a break, y'all. We'll be
go.
Back in a minute.
We
all right?
Go to Alabama.
Good morning,
Orlando. You tried to get in the car.
Yeah, but you don't know how to do it 100%.
Near Fairbanks Avenue, we're seeing slowdowns from Fairbanks Avenue to Princeton Street. The Florida's Turnpike is checking in problem free at this time, and we're in great shape across the 408 and the Greenway. See traffic problems? Call the traffic tip line at #250. Keyword, Orlando traffic. From the Traffic Center, I'm Tiana Flipping.
Need a new roof? How about Impact Doors and Windows? SSI Roofing, Impact Windows and Doors is your one-stop construction company here for you, so you don't have to outsource multiple companies. SSI Roofing, Impact Windows and Doors does commercial and residential.
Let me try with the number one more time now. I think we're good.
Facebook and Instagram, and read our 5-star reviews. Serving all of South Florida, from West Palm, Fort Lauderdale, Miami. Visit SSI Construction.
Can I just read it to you up here?
Yep, go for it.
All right. Number is 407-757-4987.
Italian food. Okay, they know we're calling, right?
Italia. Maybe.
Orlando's best-kept secret in beautiful Waterford Lakes. Papalozzi Italia is where you can eat exquisite fine dining Italian dishes at affordable prices, and our portions are large. Check out our 5-star reviews on Facebook, Google, and Yelp. Come once, and you'll be a customer for life. Papalozzi Italia, 407-412-5416. 407-412-5416. Or visit papalozziorlando.com. That's papalozziorlando.com.
Need RSVPs or ticket sales for your event? Are you a coach or athletic director? AthleticJunctionEvents.com makes buying and selling tickets.
Window voicemail.
AthleticJunctionEvents.com allows your fans to pre-purchase tickets. It's your one-stop shop for all registrations, ticket sales, apparel, and ad space for your fundraising needs. It's free to use and generate more revenue. Download Athletic Junction Events from your app store. Visit AthleticJunctionEvents.com to sign up. Embrace your journey with Athletic Junction, where life and motion meet. Selling your home? Pay 1% commission instead of 6% or more. Get the same service for thousands less with Save on Your Homes. Read the reviews on Facebook. Buying a home or new construction? It's free to use Save on Your Homes, and they rebate 1% of the purchase price towards closing costs. Go to SaveOnYourHomes.com. Try Save on Your Homes once, and they'll be your agents for life. Call 407-564-1077. That's 407-564-1077. SaveOnYourHomes.com. Empire Network Realty.
Saver, Walgreens here. We like the way you save. Take coffee. You know it doesn't have to cost $4 a cup, so you make your own. And co-pays on Medicare Part D. You save up to $5 and get 100 Valence Rewards points on each prescription when Walgreens is your preferred pharmacy. Save smartly on Med D. Walgreens, trusted since 1901. Co-pay savings on Tier 1 generic drugs available through select plans that include Walgreens as a preferred pharmacy. Points cannot be earned in Arkansas, New Jersey, or New York. Complete details at walgreens.com/balance.
This is the sound of doing in the new 2020 Nissan Titan. With America's best truck limited warranty, 5 years, 100,000 miles, bumper to bumper, this is the new 2020 Nissan Titan. This is tech for doing. Claim based on years, mileage, whichever occurs first, covered under the new vehicle limited warranty basic coverage. Warrants in-market large pickup segmentation and small pickup segmentation versus 2020 Titan and Titan XD. Nissan's new vehicle limited warranty basic coverage excludes tires, corrosion coverage, and federal and California emission performance and defect coverage. Other terms and conditions also apply. See dealer for complete warranty details.
Hi, my name is Hannah, and I like Chick-fil-A nuggets because they are made with love. It's kind of like if you want to go to your grandmother's house for dinner. It's going to be your real home-cooked meal. You can't go wrong with it.
Hey, y'all, I'm Maddie, and something I love about the Chick-fil-A nuggets is their gold color. It lets me know that I'm about to enjoy something hot and delicious. It's just comfort food. It feels good to eat.
Real guests paid for their testimonial.
This is Jesse's O'Reilly Auto Parts story.
As a nurse, not making it to work was not just an option. But driving through the snow with my wiper blades struggling, I just didn't feel safe. So I pulled into O'Reilly Auto Parts, and before I knew it, an employee was offering to install the wiper blades on my car. I got to stay out of the snow for a moment, and I still made it to work on time.
You know what I mean? Going to see them number one teams. You know what I'm talking about?
It was about a baseball team.
Yeah,
I saw that.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jim Ross, WWE Hall of Fame. Action.
Oh, here we go.
96.9 The Game.
Here we go.
Slobber knocker time.
Now, back to the WSA, WorldSportsAlumni.com Hour, with the Brandon Merriweather Show. with his realist co-host Tori Lewis. Presented by SaveOnYourHomes.com.
Yo! What's up, y'all? And we back. Listen, man, I just had to school Tori on, you know, a couple things in the first, you know, the first 30 minutes of the show. Because this boy don't understand. Everybody cheats. It's just only the good ones know how to cheat and win. You know what I mean? Like I was saying, every sport's cheat. Mm-hmm. Alabama paying their players.
Put some respect on our name.
If you don't
those
think
allegations out there like that, listen, in the air, in the universe, in the airwaves,
listen to me,
like
listen
that,
to me, man. I'm one of them people who I got stories, but I ain't no snitch. You know what I mean?
So we don't want to hear none of it.
You know what I mean? I got some Nick Saban. I got some saving stories. You know what I mean?
Right. Well, keep them in your pocket.
But is that what I'm gonna do?
Keep them in your pocket.
Is that what I'm gonna do?
Cause snitches get stitches.
I ain't worried about that part though.
You
but
got them right now.
But listen to me, I do. Well, actually, I just got them took out. Actually, but listen, what I'm saying is, every team that's any good doing something they not supposed to.
Okay.
Every team. Just some people get caught.
Okay. The Red Sox have that like Apple Watch.
Hey.
They did.
Hey, stay up on my team. he in there Googling stuff, trying to find out everybody who cheat. Yeah. Everybody cheat.
They cheat with an Apple
Watch. Hey. The Yankees got steroids.
Wow.
You know what I mean? So
what's going on in the world of NBA, man? Talk to me.
All right, man, let's move on. But hey, listen, hey, D Gordon, if you D Flash Gordon, if you listening, bro, I need you to call in so we could talk about this baseball real quick. I want you to tell me. Or Mr. Weeks. You know what I mean?
My Canes fam.
You know what I mean? If you listen to, hey, call in. I need y'all to talk about this. Any one of my baseball homeboys.
Or Ricky Weeks,
homeboys,
if you listening. Ricky Weeks Jr., if you listening. The older brother. Call us.
Any one of my homeboys. If y'all listening, man, call in real quick, man.
479-16-8255.
You know what I mean? So we can talk about this baseball. And I want to know y'all opinion because y'all actually in the sport.
He's calling.
D calling. Hey, tell him to call in to the show.
Hey, D.
You know what I mean? All right, so let's move on.
He called in?
Let's move on, man.
He said call you?
Hey, Charlie, bro, we trying to have a show, bro. You got it, you know what I mean?
Hold on a second. All right, you have I'm going to text you the number to call in.
I mean?
In the world of NBA.
Hey, all right, so in the world of NBA, that young bull, huh?
Zion? I'm going to text you the number to call in if you call in now.
Okay. He don't look like he's slowing down at all.
He took advantage of an old man last night.
Oh, come on,
he
man.
He took advantage of a Carmelo Anthony last night. And no shade on Zion, because Zion's an animal. But last night, once again, people showed you why Melo was not on the first to call this. Yes, Melo, he hit a couple of nice shots. You know, he hit Zion for one of them last night, had the crowd going crazy. He did a nice move on Zion, but for the most part, it shows why he was not on the first to call this.
What are you talking about?
But Zion was
Zion
an animal
been
last
doing
night.
That to everybody.
But Zion was animal last night.
He been doing that to everybody. He did. What you mean? He did that to Buddy from Milwaukee.
But when you say everybody, that means everybody, right?
That mean everybody.
Not in the state folk, not in the LA. We don't play
mean?
That.
What you mean?
What do you mean?
He ain't dropped 25 against the Lakers.
When was that?
Let's look this up.
Get on your Google.
The young bull dropped 25 or better against everybody.
Get on your Google. Get on your Google, because right now you talking blasphemy.
I'm telling you.
Talking about everybody.
Everybody.
Don't do that.
Everybody. The man dropped 25 against everybody.
But on a serious note, a note of concern, NBA, we happen to live in an NBA city. Brandon Merriweather, what is going on with the Orlando Magic?
Hey, hold on. We gotta call him. Hold on. We gotta
call. Okay.
Yo. What's up, bruh?
You already know me, boy. I hear you in Arizona grinding.
Oh, you already out there?
Yeah, I got out here a few days ago, bro.
Congrats on your little one. Congrats.
Yes sir. Appreciate you, boy. Ain't nothing like that, daddy.
I'm trying to tell you. Hey, D, but I got a question for you, D.
What's up, bro?
So, do you think they need to take the ship away from the asteroids?
Bruh, I'm going to keep the lid with you, bro. If they wanted to, they would have done it.
I agree with that.
If they wanted to, they would have done it.
But do you think they should?
Why now? I wouldn't want a secondhand trophy. You feel me?
How about they just vacate the trophy? And if they take it from it, nobody gets it.
That's weak. You know what I'm saying? It just is what it is. If you're going to do it, just do it. But don't do it not because everybody owns you. Don't do it because everybody hitting all these lights and stuff. That's too late. You knew what was the right thing to do. We know right from wrong. You get. When we mess up, we got to stand up for it. But, you know what I'm saying? Everybody ain't held up to that stomach.
D, I'm trying to tell this man, everybody cheat a little bit, man. You know what I mean? It just, they got caught. You know what I mean?
Everybody do, bro.
I'm trying to tell this man.
You always want an edge, bro. You always want an edge.
And D, that's not what I was saying. D, what I was saying was that they went above and beyond because we know we've been stealing signs since Little League. But what I'm saying is when you start doing what they did, that's on a whole nother stratosphere there. You know what I'm saying? If you get to second base and you can see what's going on and you remember what's going on, that's one thing. But when you start pulling out the videos and we got the little buzzers on and we hit the trash can two times and we looking, you know, we getting way out there now. My thing is this. We know what they did was wrong, but this is what I'm trying. You know, as a commissioner, you always try to prevent it from happening again. So everybody's looking at how you do it. So everybody say, okay, if you ain't take it, and all you're doing is just a little slap on the wrist, and if nobody stitched it, we good. Because basically, if the guy didn't...
They do it again.
Let's run it back. If the pitcher didn't say nothing, nobody would know it anyway. If Harold didn't say that, we all good. So basically, what we saying in the Bronx, we might run it by.
Right. I just don't like how people call that brother a kid. You feel me?
Right. And he did that last night. David Ortiz did that last night. Yesterday, rather.
I don't know who said
it. It was on ESPN. Like, David Ortiz did it. I put my name on it. David Ortiz said it.
Like, people shitted on that man. Like, you feel me?
Right.
They shitted on that man. he shitted back on y'all.
Right, absolutely.
But people don't like that of power, bro. When you a power, you don't think nothing gonna happen to you. We all seen our best, you know, like gangster movies. They think they're a power to do any and everything. But at one day, you're gonna have to bow down. We all gotta meet our maker, man. And it just got caught.
Absolutely.
You feel me?
Yeah.
Good thing here for me, man. Shoot, I just be playing anyway, so I don't care what you got going on.
Right.
Boy, you just said a mouthful right there, boy.
What you mean?
You just said a mouthful, boy. You just keep playing, D, man. I'm proud of you, bro.
That's it, bro. Play ball, baby. They got to pay on that first and 15.
Hey. Hey, I got this young boy over here. Hey, man, what about you? What you think about them Canes being number one in the nation?
Like the Hurricanes?
Yeah, in baseball. We number one in the nation in baseball, huh?
Everybody them, I don't call it baseball.
Yeah, we do.
They're the boy that can make you drown,
good. Hey D, get off my team, D.
Oh, D, get off my team, D. You know I'm a
get off my team, D.
All right,
D, man, I thank you for calling in, D. I appreciate you, bro.
Yes, sir, man.
All right, boy, we over and out.
Thanks, Steve, for calling in.
All right, man, so let's move on, man. Let's get on this basketball, because that young boy, Zion, looked like a man playing against boys.
Yes, he does.
And you know what? I just looked it up. He haven't played the Lakers yet.
Like I said, you said everybody.
You think somebody? You think the Lakers gonna?
We don't play that.
You think the Lakers gonna stop him?
We got the biggest team in the league. You ain't finna hang out on the rim with us. We don't play that, man.
He might bring the rim down on y'all.
Okay. We'll see. We don't play that.
We need to find out when they play. We need to find out when they play.
But I asked you early before D called in was the fact of the state of the Magic. What is going on with Orlando Magic? Where is the direction going? I don't know. You being a Magic fan, let me know what you see.
You know what I think the Magic need to do?
What's up?
Fire everybody.
From top down. Okay, top down.
Fire everybody.
Okay.
And I'm going to tell you what they need to do. Who started the Golden State franchise? Who started the Golden State to what it is now?
I guess you would kind of give the... At the end of the day, you give it to Joe Lacob. I mean, you would have to start with the ownership, realizing that this is what we need to do.
But who they brought in to right them wrongs that they've been having for years?
Before Steve Kerr, you're saying?
Yeah.
Don Nelson was up in the front office at one time.
I'm talking about the head coach. Who was the head coach?
Talking about Mark Jackson?
Absolutely.
So you want Mark Jackson in Orlando?
Absolutely. He drafted Clay. He drafted Draymond. He drafted Steph. He drafted, he the one wrong in.
So you're saying go get Mark Jackson.
Listen, only thing Steve Kerr did, honestly, only thing Steve Kerr did.
Is keep it going.
Is let them boys do what they do best. That's right. They was already doing what they do now.
Mark Jackson
put all the seasoning in it. He put everything in it, and all Steve Kerr did was took it out of the oven.
So you're saying the Magic need to fire everybody in the front office?
Everybody.
Bring in Mark Jackson.
Everybody. Bring him in. Bring in Mark Jackson and say, hey, look, man, you got 5 years. Make it happen.
So you're saying that the Warriors would have became what they became even without Steve Kerr there?
If they didn't get Mark Jackson, they still would have won. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, we got a caller, y'all. Let me see who it is. Yo.
Yo, how's it going?
What's up? Who we speaking with?
This is Sean up in Boston.
What's up, Sean?
Oh, yeah.
So you're a Red Sox fan, huh?
Yeah. I didn't mean to interrupt the NBA talk to get back to baseball, but
you're good.
You guys were talking. I agree with the both of you, kind of like, everyone's doing it, but they did take it to the next level with the electronic stuff, but you can't take the titles away. I'm not just saying that as a Sox fan, because it's where does it end? I hate that they do it in college sports. It makes no sense to me. And then you guys were also talking about David Ortiz. He's also now like part of the Red Sox front office, pretty much. He's one of their mouthpieces. He's going to be talking to them, for them, as much as anybody. He made another like weird comment the other day about they couldn't pay Mookie Betts, and like he was one of the guys when he was playing, never shut up about getting himself paid. But you know, now that he's front office, it's a different opinion, and I think it's the same with the electronic stuff. He's going to be talking with whatever John Henry and that ownership group wants them to be saying.
Hey, listen, right? And I'm saying this with the most up respect to D. But everybody gotta have a puppet.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason you bring Ortiz in is because he's a well liked puppet.
Similar to Emmitt Smith and you can't bring
Brandon Merriweather in, because Brandon Merriweather gonna say what he wanna say. Like, you could tell me to say one thing, and I might agree with you right there, but when I get in front of the mic, I don't know what I'm going to say. So, I get it. And David Ortiz is a well-liked puppet. That's what he is.
Oh, he's loved. He is.
Absolutely.
And I like him, too. It's just disappointing. He kind of has gone this way. I get it, though, but it's a little tough to hear as a fan of his from everything he's done on the field for the Sox.
Absolutely. But we got to go on a break right now, man. Thank you for calling. I appreciate it.
Oh, thank you. It's a great show. And you're great up in on Toucher and Rich as well.
Oh, thank you, man. I appreciate you. Yeah.
All right. Have a good one.
You too, brother. I need some TWD, some future, something. I'm tired of telling you, man. You're giving me all this here, man. 70s. You give me Leonard Skinner and all this other stuff. Try you. Can't
deny you. Selling your home? Pay 1% commission instead of 6% or more. Get the same service for thousands less with Save on Your Homes. Read the reviews on Facebook. Buying a home or new construction? It's free to use Save on Your Homes, and they rebate 1% of the purchase price towards closing costs. Go to SaveOnYourHomes.com. Try Save on Your Homes once, and they'll be your agents for life. Call 407-564-1077. That's 407-564-1077. SaveOnYourHomes.com.
Is he the two states? You either go to Florida, Texas, or Florida.
But the last, he told me while I looked it up too, the last six Florida Georgia games, Georgia beat 4-5 in a row. You won the last one. You played it was the last time Florida won. So they lost 5 in a row before that.
Another thing is too about that. Listen, this is another thing that's not even spoken about. Is remember, the kids got a decision to make. Because it's not that Florida was Georgia was better than us. A lot of our kids chose to play in two other games.
Yeah. We played another thing. We had the Florida Cali game, Florida Georgia game, and the U.S.
All-American game. So kids looking at, that's nothing. How much gear you giving me, what you're doing for me, like you said before, for me to play in this
song. I'm going
to
tell you the problem, y'all going
to
tell me.
Guaranteed to make memories for life. Even if one is family owned, and we have
the
best
prices for others,
and
we can
work
within your budget.
Whether
it's a birthday party, baby shower, or a corporate event, call 855-550-DJ4U. That's 855-550-DJ4U. Or visit eventonefl.com.
I guess he knows the
schedule. All the controversy, news, trades, and scores. Stay in the game on iHeartRadio. Download the app for free at 96.9thegame.com.
Florida Door Solutions is Central Florida's most trusted residential and commercial overhead door company, and they're family owned. They're state-of-the-art Florida licensed and insured, offering fully stocked service vehicles with factory trained technicians. Call 407-884-5955 to schedule today. Visit their showroom to see the latest designs or visit fladoor.com. Florida Door Solutions,
proud partner of the World Sports Alumni Show.
How do you tell her that she's special, that she's extraordinary, that she's the one? Come in today to Casa Leon Jewelers. Let us give you the power of knowledge, the power of knowing that you're giving her the very best. Casa Leon Jewelers is proud to bring its legendary service and experience of 75 years to Lake Mary. Show her that she's the one and shop our selection of designer jewelry with prices starting at $199. Casa Leon Jewelers, your local jeweler in Lake Mary.
My son was playing in the finals, which I hated to miss, but I had a big deadline at work. Thanks to Total Wireless, my husband streamed the game to me over the nation's best network.
Yep, I'm your cameraman.
It was awesome.
Except for how tired my arms got.
Aw, thanks, babe. You got this with Total Wireless. Get an unlimited plan for $25 a month, no contract, with a gig of high-speed data than 2G on the nation's best 4G LTE network. Total Wireless, total confidence. Available at Target. See terms and conditions at totalwireless.com.
130, just another number, right? Think again. It can mean all sorts of bad things. Swimming is great, but swimming with 130 sharks is a bad idea. 130 is too much of a lot of things, and it's too high for blood pressure. A blood pressure reading of 130 over 80 or higher means you're more likely to have a stroke or heart attack. Visit heart.org/HBP to find out more about controlling your blood pressure.
96.9 The Game. FM,
I guess because of Florida,
HD,
Orlando,
and 96.9thegame.com on your phone with the iHeartRadio and on hundreds of devices like Alexa, Google Home, Xbox, and Sonos.
I know, but if you had
an iHeartRadio station.
Let's go.
Now, back to the WSA, WorldSportsAlumni.com Hour, with the Brandon Merriweather Show, with his realist co-host, Tori Lewis. Presented by SaveOnYourHomes.com.
Why I gotta say the realist co-host?
I'm the realist out here.
No, I mean,
I'm the realist out here.
Why I can't just
because
say?
Because everybody
Mid
know.
Tori
everybody
Lewis.
Know that I'm gonna give you the real. I'm the realist out here, man. I'm gonna give you the realist.
Hey, you
out
used to
here.
Get beat up a lot, huh?
For what reason? I got all my teeth. Ain't no scars in my face.
He used to get beat up a lot.
How
had
you figure that? How you figure
that? Had to, man. You had
I'm too
to.
Pretty to get beat up. I'm too pretty for that. These hands too good for that. Come on now. No. Not Vanessa's son.
I hit home. Not you, at you all. You feel a little salty, huh?
Not at all. They know my resume. All
right, man. So, back to what we were talking about, the magic. Right,
the magic.
And I was saying, I personally think they just need to fire everybody.
Everybody. Well, let's look at the players. Let's take a deep dive and look at the players. Look at the roster right currently, because it's like the magic every year getting players that are development.
They're getting hurt players.
Right. Well, they drafted a hurt guy from Auburn.
You drafted the hurt guy from Auburn, who's supposed to be a lottery pick. But just listen to me, right? So you get him, you bring in Phelps, who was hurt. Even back in the days, you bring Grant Hill, that was hurt. Okay. Like, you bring everybody you bring here be hurt.
And then you get Mbamba. Mbamba is his name, the 7-footer that never played basketball.
Yeah, and ain't did nothing. Right. Ain't did nothing.
He was lost on the court last
waste
night.
Of time.
He was lost.
Waste of time. You know what I mean?
Right.
Now, do I think, you know, you hit home with Aaron Gordon? I don't think you hit home, but I do see him as, you know, a decent player coming. You know, he gonna be good eventually.
He's a side. He's not the main course.
Correct.
He's
correct.
A side.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay. And they're trying to make him the main course.
Right. And he ain't and there. Like then you draft Oladipo and you let him go.
Right. Right.
Like everybody who you should keep, you let go.
Right.
So that means it's a problem in the office, man. It's a problem in the front office. You know what I mean?
And you get a coach that's the head coach of your team that's been fired somewhere else. That has not won. I
mean, everybody been fired.
But
though.
No, I can't agree with that.
He
was fired for the same reason he's doing right now. He does not produce offensive teams. That's why Michael Jordan got rid of him. Because his team's gonna be, they're gonna score 80, 90 points. They're gonna be great defensive teams, but they have no offense. He's a defensive coach. And here you go again, you can't score. The NBA is a make or miss league. You gotta be able to score.
I agree.
We don't need no defensive coach. You need in the NBA, you need offensive coaches. Because that's what the league is predicated on, offense.
I
you don't need Bill Belichick in the NBA.
I kind of agree, but I disagree.
Every game is in the hundreds, Brandon. Every game is in the hundreds now. That's not the basketball you grew up on.
It's just hard for me to agree with that, man. That's just hard for me to agree with.
Guys, listen. When you grew up, it was no defenders everywhere. Now, it's only one dude on every team that play defense. Everybody else can score. They call him the lockdown man. You know what I'm saying? Like, so why you go get a defensive-minded coach in an offensive-driven league?
Look
at the scores.
My problem is, hold on. This is my problem, right?
Mm-hmm.
How can you say he defensive-minded when you got, you know, Luke Dunley going for 35? Like, that's what I'm saying. How can you say he defensive-minded, yo?
I'm saying that because
Boston wants somebody foul him or do something, man.
First of all, there's nobody on your roster that can contain Luka or Porzingis. Like we just talked about, the quality of players you got, period. And if we be real about it, Luka doing that against everybody anyway.
I agree.
But so you do need somebody. But Luka ain't known to play no defense. He's not a defensive stopper.
I agree.
So my thing is, you got, like last night they missed like their first 7-8 threes and it was wide open. The Magic don't even have a bona fide score. A guy that you can say, go get buckets. They don't even have that. That you get a ball to and say, go get me some.
So tell me this. Why no superstars want to come to Orlando?
I don't want to believe that. You know why I don't like believing it when people say stuff like that? Because that's what I'm saying. I don't want to believe that. Because everybody that we know that's an athlete lives here. In the offseason. So it's not
players.
Like it's a...
No.
We have a lot of... And basketball.
No, we don't. We ain't got a lot of basketball. We got a lot of baseball and a lot of football. We ain't got a lot of basketball players.
They do have houses here.
No. Everybody who had a house here sold it. Everybody.
Don't do
everybody.
That.
I'm dead serious.
Okay. But anyway, I don't know why. Because we got no state taxes.
Right.
I would have to blame the front office.
That's my whole thing. How can you not?
Because at the end of the day, when you look at what the Magic put out there and you look at the front office and the coach, you're like, no, I ain't going to play for that. I'm good. I don't want to think it's this. It's not the city.
It ain't the city. Of course it's not the city because, you know, you got Disney here. You got University. You got all this. It's not the city.
Remember you had all those great coaches on the market just last three or four years?
Yeah.
Imagine them going down one and they go get the guy you never heard of. Like, what?
Man, you need to go get Mark Jackson. That's what I'm telling you. Get Mark Jackson the keys. Say, huh, man, here go the keys to the Bentley. You do what you want to do. Listen, I ain't going to even lie to you. I'm just a fan of Mark Jackson. If you get Mark Jackson, if they bring Mark Jackson in here, I'm going to buy season.
But as a basketball fan, how can you sit there every night and watch the Magic and they're giving you that? As a Magic fan. I mean, just at some point, when the Magic fans going to require them to do better? You know, because I don't understand the Magic. I really don't. It's like you take three steps forward, you take 10 steps backwards each year, every year.
Listen, I think the Magic just seem like they just in a whole different ball game when it come to playing people, man. That's all.
You under 500 again. You 24-32 again. And this is the story every season with the Magic. But in other news, how about those Lakers? The Lakers doing another move. They're doing another move. They match it. The Clippers got Marcus Morris this week, right? The twin.
Okay.
The Lakers come right back, and the Lakers sign Markieff Morris.
The twin?
Yeah.
Why would they do that?
Both of them average the same. Their game is identical.
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
I don't know if I agree with that.
You can look it up.
I don't know if I agree with that.
Their games are identical.
You know,
their games always been like they're going back to Kansas.
One of them got the attitude that make you say, "Hey, man, listen, we need him. We need him." Like, and the other one kind of more like chill, like,
The one that got the attitude is the one that signed with the Lakers.
No, the one with the attitude is the one that signed with the...
Just saw the stat last night. He's the one that's led the league in personal fouls.
That don't mean you got attitude.
No. What I'm saying is...
Just because you're a hacker, that don't mean you got attitude.
What I'm saying is...
Brother.
What I'm saying is...
That's how I know you used to get beat up.
He's the one known to be very aggressive. I don't know, where did that come from?
That's how I know.
That got to come from that kind of left field. You was tripping. Did you take your medication this morning? Did you take your single dose?
If anybody in here, you know, used to beat up Tori, y'all call in, man.
Please do. Please do. And if you used to beat up Brandon off 10th Street over at Taylor Apartments or Lake Jewel, please call
in. Y'all call in, man.
479-168-2555.
I want to know.
1-800-729-8255.
I want to know, man.
If you
man.
Were in Apopka and you was born and raised with Brandon over off 10th Street or Taylor's or over off Lake Jewel somewhere, and you used to take his flip from him, please call in. Because they told me he used to cry a lot when he was little. I heard about it. He used to cry a lot when he was little.
Hey, boy, I used to get beat up for crying, boy.
I'm not surprised.
Sam,
you like a little crybaby.
No.
Hey, Tori, you're a Marine, right?
Absolutely. 2nd Battalion, 6th Marines.
So you had to do combat training.
Absolutely.
That don't mean you can fight.
You see how serious my face just got?
That don't mean you can fight.
He didn't hesitate.
You see how serious my face just got then when he mentioned that 2nd Battalion, 6th Marines?
That don't mean you can fight, though. That don't mean that.
No, it does
not. There's a lot of boxers that can't fight, too.
That one almost got you knocked out last week.
No, that almost got you knocked out.
You knocked out last week when you told Peter, talking about he not an athlete, you don't have to be a super athlete, the train, you almost got knocked out last week. The only thing saved you was the fact he felt sorry for you.
Hold on, we gotta call him. Yo.
Yeah, hello.
Hey, we gotta go on break right now, man. We'll call, can you stay on hold for a second?
Sure, no problem.
All right, we got to go on break right now.
That's the coach. Tell me to hang up my call back. Tell me to call back then. Hey.
Never in my feelings. Don't do that there, man. Love can't put me in my
feelings. WYGF Orlando. WJRR HD2 Cocoa Beach, Orlando. This is FM 96.9 The Game. The home of the Orlando Magic.
Hey, Ricky Sr. Some great information. I'm good. We're on our radio show right now. We're live on it. And you're producing it. But we're talking baseball for a while today. If you want, if you're free, could you call? I'm going to text you that number, I think. Can you call in about maybe like
four people
about 30 minutes?
$200 a month. Then if you want to do live guests, if you want to have guests, you want to have guests.
Okay, it's no big deal. Actually, we had D. Gordon on. He called in. So.
They charge. $350.
But yeah, if you want to call, because right now we have the coach from Ford Gordon's game calling in right now. So, maybe call in. I know who I'm calling. I was texting Jamal earlier.
Yeah.
I'll how about this? This is a bad time for you. We'll have you call in another show.
I know that, but I talked to him.
Yeah.
Hey, who's that that's calling in?
Asta Superstores of Central Florida Studios. Now, with two Orlando locations.
I got two callers, one in the
We'll organize it better next time. Okay?
What's the name?
We are FM 96.9 The Game.
This report is sponsored by Taco Bell. Take the game with you wherever you go on iHeartRadio.
Delays starting to build up on I-4 eastbound this morning from US 27 to State Road 429. You're also going to see heavy traffic headed eastbound from Osceola Parkway to just past State Road 535.
You want to do a couple
watch
of sponsors?
Watch for slowdowns on I-4 westbound.
You got a wait on line one.
Right,
I think the other guy's hung up.
Fairbanks to Minnesota Avenue. And watch for a crash on I-4 eastbound at Fairbanks on the exit ramp. If you do see traffic problems, call the Safe Touch Security traffic tip line, #250, keyword Orlando traffic. From the traffic center, I'm Tyler McCullough.
Taco Bell's Nacho Fries return in a story about two friends who dive into the underground market of Mexican spices and warm nacho cheese sauce. Learn from their mistakes. Get your Nacho Fries today for a limited time at a participating Taco Bell location near you.
Event One strives to be your one-stop solution for your special day. Whether you need uplighting, DJ, karaoke, custom monograms, or even vintage video games, Event One has you covered.
And all right, and you got a TJ Bannister on line three.
To make memories for life, Event One is family-owned, and we have the best prices in the business, and we can work within your budget. Whether it's a birthday party, baby shower, or corporate event, call 855-550-DJ4U. That's 855-550-DJ4U. Or visit EventOneFL.com.
Come to Wings, Wings, Wings in Apopka and taste the best chicken wings you've ever had. Wings, Wings, Wings gets all their chicken wings from local farms and serves every customer fresh to order. Flavors like jerk, garlic parmesan, Hawaiian barbecue, or the owner NFL pro bowler Brandon Merriweather's famous vodka wings, and more. Wings, Wings, Wings is the official wing spot of the Merriweather Dixon Show. Located at 452 North Park Avenue, Apopka. Open Tuesday through Sunday. And like them on Facebook at Wings, Wings, Wings.
Need a new roof? How about Impact Doors and Windows? SSI Roofing, Impact Windows and Doors is your one-stop construction company here for you so you don't have to outsource multiple companies. SSI Roofing, Impact Windows and Doors does commercial and residential, no matter how big or small the job. With 30 years of experience, find us on Facebook and Instagram and read our 5-star reviews. Serving all of South Florida from West Palm, Fort Lauderdale, Miami. Visit SSIConstructionInc.com or call 954-771-DOOR. 954-771-DOOR.
Need RSVPs or ticket sales for your event? Are you a coach or athletic director? AthleticJunctionEvents.com makes buying and selling tickets easy. AthleticJunctionEvents.com allows your fans to pre-purchase tickets. It's your one-stop shop for all registrations, ticket sales, apparel, and ad space for your fundraising needs. It's free to use and generate more revenue. Download Athletic Junction Events from your app store. Visit AthleticJunctionEvents.com to sign up. Embrace your journey with Athletic Junction, where life and motion meet.
I thought he had an Achilles.
Don't want to decide which streaming services to pay for? How about getting Tubi instead? One, Tubi is free, and two, they got thousands of movies and TV shows to choose from. Oh, and three, it's free. I know that was number one, but also, it's free. So yeah, Tubi's not like other streaming services. It's better and freer, and you can stream it anytime on any device. So what are you waiting for? Try it out, yes, for free, and download Tubi, T-U-B-I, today.
Hi, my name is Hannah, and I like Chick-fil-A nuggets because they are made with love. It's kind of like if you want to go to your grandmother's house for dinner. It's going to be a real home-cooked meal. You can't go wrong with it.
Hey, y'all, I'm Maddie, and something I love about the Chick-fil-A nuggets is their gold color. It lets me know that I'm about to enjoy something hot and delicious. It's just comfort food. It feels good to eat.
Real guests paid for their testimonial.
Let's talk about Daniel. A year ago, he resolved to stop putting off what he wanted to do. Yet in the information technology, Daniel enrolled in My Computer Career and is now already a few months into his IT career. Make 2020 your year. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and take the free career evaluation today. You can start your new life as an IT pro in as little as 4 months. Classes meet on campus or live online just 2 times a week. It's not rocket science. It's My Computer Career. mycomputercareer.edu.
Monday night, the Magic take on the Brooklyn Nets. Pregame at 7 and tip-off at 7:30. Listen live on FM 96.9 The Game and AM 740.
I texted him, man.
The following is a paid program. The views and opinions expressed in this program are not those of iHeartMedia, its management, or advertisers.
Why are we doing that all
again? Now, back to the WSA. WorldSportsAlumni.com Hour with the Brandon Merriweather Show.
Hey, what number TJ on?
Co-host Tori Lewis. Presented by SaveOnYourHomes.com.
Line three.
Yo, what's up, y'all? And we back, man.
We back, baby.
Save Your Home, best realtor in Central Florida. They only charge 1% commission for selling your home and buying with them, and they will rebate 1% of the purchase price towards your closing cost. Check out Delray Beach Tennis, open today and tomorrow. Some of the best ATP tennis stars playing in it. Tickets at yellowtennisball.com. Not yet. Hey, TJ.
TJ.
Yo. What's up, boy?
What's going on, bro?
Hey, man. Listen, man. You know, you one of the best basketball players I know. You know what I mean?
Right.
Hey, so I got a question for you. And I know you're a Magic fan. You know what I mean? I see you at the game sitting on courtside. You know what I mean? I see you. You know what I'm saying? Right. You ain't took your boy yet. You know what I mean? But we're going to talk about that later. So, TJ, tell me this. What you think the problem is with the Magic?
Honestly, bro, it's just hard. You can't teach hard. Some players got it. Some players don't. You know, a lot of that NBA, if we had a couple more Giannis's out there, then it'd be a different story. You know what I mean? I'm like, you don't need too many superstars. All you need is just some people that want to play together, play hard, and just play with some heart.
So you think
that's easy basketball?
So tell me this: you don't think Mark Jackson will come in and change that thing around, man?
Honestly, I think he deserves another chance in the league. I feel like he deserves another chance. I mean, you know, we had this coach. How long we had this coach for? What? Three years.
Yeah, it's been three years.
So. Yeah, man, I think it's about time to try to make some changes. I mean, I don't know what else they need to see from him. I mean, we always start off hot, then we start going super cool. So, I mean, I think it's about time to make a change. Change is always good anyway, you know.
Why we keep getting all these hurt players, man?
Bro, I have no clue. No clue, man. I can't answer that one. I have no clue, bro.
TJ, I got a question for you. You being a Magic fan.
I got an answer for you.
All right, two things I've noticed with the Magic is they keep drafting kids that have to, they have to develop, and the Magic are not known as a development organization. You drafted Correct. You drafted him, Mbamba, and you drafted mm-hmm. the kid from Florida State, Isaac. What his name is?
Jonathan Isaac. Yeah.
Which we all knew those kids was had to be developed, and hey, right. and even Aaron Gordon was a kid that had to be developed. Because honestly, Aaron right. Gordon still has not developed. He uses his athleticism. That's why some games he'll get 25, some games he only get 4.
Agreed.
So my thing is, why we keep drafting kids that we have to develop and we not have a development coach staff?
I mean, honestly, when you look at the NBA, all they do is go off of kids' potential. So when they're coming out of the league, I mean, I remember back when I was coming out and Chris Paul was coming out, bro. All they looked at was, back then, what they might have potential to do,
right?
You know, and I think a lot of those lower level teams, they get so caught up in the, oh well, they say that this kid might be this and that, so let me go after this kid. Versus, what about Chris Paul? They, you know, everyone the knock was on him was that he was too small, but now you look at him and he's one of the top 3, top 5 point guards in the NBA, and everything that he did coming out of Wake Forest is the same exact thing that he did now. But all they were saying is what he couldn't do, rather than what he can do, and that's always been a knock on, that's my only issue I've ever had with the NBA, is that instead of them taking players on doing stuff that they can do right now, how they can come and impact the game right now, they're just looking at potential, and potential will get you, you know, if you don't have that heart and have that work ethic, then you're just going to stay the same exact player, and that's what happened with a lot of players. And speaking on Aaron Gordon, like you said, he hasn't developed at all. Like, he doesn't have a left hand. He's super strong, athletic, gonna go right. Jump shot still suspect. So that's not. But to his defense, I think that he should be putting in. I don't know what type of work he's putting in off the court, but you know you can't get to the NBA and get satisfied. So like you going to finish answering your question, I have no clue why they're going after players that you know you need to develop. Like you say, the Magic isn't an organization that develops players. So in my opinion, I think we need to start going after more players that can actually impact our game like right away. You know, Somebody like Jason Tatum. Tatum, you know, he could help us out, you know?
Right.
Or making some trades. Like, we got a roster full of guys off of potential.
Hey, TJ, I got one more question for you. You know, before we have to go, I got one question for you.
Okay.
Why the Magic can't get no superstars to come here?
No superstar want to lose.
I guess it's that easy, huh?
Bro, if I'm looking at teams that I can go to, I'm trying to go get me a chip. I look at the Magic over the last few years, actually, the last 5-6 years, we not getting nothing done, bro. We not making it far in the playoffs. So why would I go put myself in a situation where I know my season's going to end early? It's that simple. Players want to win. It's all about championships.
I mean, it was just a few years ago that the Magic were at the NBA Finals. And then
no, that's more than a few years ago.
Yeah, that was like 10.
Yeah, that was,
but why? But yeah, how is the apple falling so far away from the tree?
Well, coaching is one, and players is the next. You got a team full of players. Like I say, off of potential, we don't have not one superstar on our team.
My point. All right, thanks, TJ, bro. Thanks,
no
TJ, bro. I appreciate you, boy.
Thank you for calling in.
Already, hey, we need to go to a game, too. Just hit me up and let me know when you're free, bro.
I'm free every day.
All right,
bro.
I'm going to look at the schedule and we'll go check it out.
All right, got you.
All right, bro.
Yeah.
Yo.
Yo, let's get us another caller, man. Yo. Yo.
Yo.
What's up?
What's going on, young man?
Can I ask who's speaking?
Leon Bright.
Leon
Bright, the guy we've been waiting to call in. Absolutely.
What's up, Leon?
You got it, man. You guys, they sound pretty good on there, man.
Thank you, man. So we haven't hit into football yet, and this is the perfect guy to get us into talking about football.
Am I?
Yeah. So I hear about this Florida Georgia game. You're trying to start back up. You know, what's your motivation behind this?
Well, you know, motivation, man, is get more kids out there, man, to be seen. I know they're seen in high school doing their games. But, you know, we want to meet those guys one-on-one, personal, and see what they're all about, man, you know, and talk to the kids about going to college, media, talking about social media, and some of the things that they're doing in school now, man, that we want to make sure that those kids are not going to be getting in trouble and all that other stuff on the social media.
So my first question, you know, because I have a lot of them, you know what I mean? But my first question is, why are you pushing the game to be over the summer instead of at the end of the year?
Well, we say at the end of the year because, you know, most of the kids now, man, if they're seniors in high school, most of them this summer they're going to go to their universities or they're going to be visiting universities. They don't have time, man, to play an all-star game because when we was coming up, man, we weren't going to school that early. You know, we was finishing the summer out. We was doing other things. But now, man, those guys are leaving early around the junior year beginning of the senior year. A lot of those kids are gone, man. So we're going to play the juniors this year that's going to be seniors, you know, and give them a little airtime too as well.
Oh, so it's for the juniors is what this is going to be?
Yeah, they're going into your senior year.
Going into your senior. Okay, okay.
But this because this is my problem with that.
Uh-huh.
Is that if my son was going to play, you know, I would say, hey, man, you need to, like, chill because what if you get nicked up? You know what I mean? And you going into your senior year, like unless you just that good of a player where people still gonna want you, like that could be a problem. You see what I'm saying? Like if you get hurt in December, like you got 8 months to heal up. You know what I mean? You could.
Right.
I came back from an ACL in 8 months. So you see what I'm saying? If you mess around and get hurt in June, then you know, it's kind of like, you know, you got to wait to college to play again. So okay, I'm listening.
But yeah, you got a lot of those kids, man. They're going in the game, man. All the game is about show anyway. You know, those guys gonna go out there. Some of those kids gonna play hard. Some of those kids not gonna play hard. And those kids know what their abilities are. You know, when they go into a game, they know what they're gonna do and what they're not gonna do when they get in that game.
This high school.
Yeah, that's high school there, man. But you know,
I understand if you're talking about college and the Senior Bowl and stuff like that. You're right, because I played in the Florida Georgia game. Like, yeah. I
played in the North Florida game, North and South game.
You know what I mean? So I understand. I know when we was playing, our whole goal was to go kill Georgia. Like if we wasn't playing with them, we ain't coming to a game saying, man, I ain't even playing that hard this game, man. You know what I mean? Because I don't want it. No, our whole goal was going in there and saying, man, we finna destroy them. And I think we beat them like 48-3 or something like that, 48-10.
Right.
You know, so.
That was it.
So what was your motivation, Brandon, for playing in it, for accepting and playing that hard?
The reason I played in that game is because I wanted to play with my homeboys. Like every other All-Star game that I got invited to, I would have been the only person playing that was from my high school. So I played in the Florida Georgia game because it was two of us that got invited. So I played in that game.
So really, you know, if the best players in the state are playing in it, then you kind of want to play in it, right? Because you see your home guys playing in it.
No. I was going to play in the U.S. Army game, and I decided to play in the Florida Georgia game because they had, you know, one of my teammates playing in that game too. So I was like, man, forget the U.S. game. I want to play with my teammates.
Right.
So with that being said, you got anything you want to say, Jordan?
All I want to know is like how are we going to do go about finding the kids to play in this game? What are the criteria of the kids that we're going to be using to play in this game?
You already got a pretty big star signed up, I believe. I heard
going at juniors.
The Apopka quarterback is already committed to playing the game. Right?
So do you send out the invitation, or do you let people come in and whoever want to play?
No. We have a list of all the kids that we looked at about 90% of the kids. You know, we get the list and then we go to different camps. We look at kids play. You know, this is all year. And then we go visit those kids. We've been in Georgia. We've been throughout Florida. We've been everywhere, man, looking for these kids. And we get them off different lists, the kids, and make this list up and try to find the best 38 from Florida, the best 38 from Georgia.
Oh, okay.
And then, mm-hmm. then we send out invitations to the – we don't send it to the kids. We send it to their head coach. And the coach pretty much decides that kid want to play or not. But if the kid – 90% of the time, the kid find out that he want to play this game and he have a piece of paper there, he got to go talk to the coach and look, coach, yeah, give him a shot at this. Because you want to prove yourself, just like you say. I want to play the best because you've been hearing about this kid here. He's all this. He's all that. You want to see if he got it. You know, do you have it? Can I play in this game? Can I play against the best players that's throughout Florida and Georgia?
I mean, you had some great players. The Florida-Georgia game has got a long, like, I think, 16-year history. So you had Deion Sanders play for Florida. Georgia guys included Hines Ward. And then you also had, of course, Brandon Merriweather.
Yeah, Derrick Brooks played in that
game. Yeah, Edrin James, of course, played for Florida in the high school game.
Listen, we got to – listen, the talent in Florida is endless. You know what I mean? I just want to know, like – because it's so many players that I'm sure I can name off the top of my head that's in high school right now that would be deserving of playing, but that's the problem. How do you like pick out of all these players? How do you pick who?
Hey, you got to go on those different lists, man. And
so are you looking at like the Rivals.com list? Are you looking at the ESPN
Rivals,
top 300?
Rivals.
ESPN top 300.
Yes, we're looking at all that.
Okay.
Three or four different lists that you're looking at, man, and see if those kids on those lists, and then that's when you pick your 38.
Okay, I got you.
All right, man.
Because my thing is 38 kids from Florida, Georgia. You know how big Florida, Georgia is, man.
Right.
If that kid there says, you know, I don't want to play this game. Right. Hey, go to the next kid because that kid just as good or better.
Right.
You absolutely right about that. But this is the last question I got before we have to go on break. Why Florida, Georgia? Like, if you're trying to go through the best talent in the U.S., I think you have to go Florida, Cali, Florida, Texas, Florida, Louisiana, Florida, Virginia. Like, I think Georgia is like tier two. You know what I mean? Like,
You hit the nail on the head. Excuse me, cutting you off. You know, you got to start somewhere. And once you start, man, and the same thing you just said, you know, you got Texas, California, you got all these, Alabama, you got all these other states, man, that we can put this thing together, man, and see the best talent in the world, really. Mm-hmm. And
man, if you want to make a good game, if you want to have a good game, do Florida versus U.S., you know what I mean? That's the only way you're going to make it competitive is if you do Florida versus the U.S. Because we just that good.
I guess all your Texas fans should call in.
Hey, you're going to get calls all over the place now.
I'm just telling you, we just that good.
That's a true statement.
We just that good. If we do Florida versus the U.S., that's the only way you make this game competitive.
We're looking at the Facebook Live. Our show is also live on Facebook, and we have a lot of fans riding in right now. A lot of fans are writing in there, so they would love to see the Florida-Georgia game come back, and they're all agreeing with each other. So, obviously, the Florida-Georgia game, high school game, has got a lot of history there, and so I think people want to see that rivalry, and I think there's an opportunity to make this great again. So I think that's pretty cool what you guys are doing, Leon.
Yo, thank you.
If you need me, Leon, man, just give Charlie a call, man. I do everything in my power to make this thing as popular and as good as we can, man. So, you know, I'm all in, man. You're doing a good thing for the kids, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you, man. You're already on the list.
All right, thank you, bro. I appreciate it. And we out.
Thank you.
And once all more, right. That's Leon Bright, former NFL player, played for the Giants and played for the Bucks.
All right, man. We got to go on break, man. Hey, tell our caller we'll be back in a second, and we got him. All right?
All right.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna go, man. If I quit your beam, I still got my seat.
Delays starting to build up on I-4 eastbound this morning from US 27 to State Road 429. You're also going to see heavy traffic headed eastbound from Osceola Parkway to just past State Road 545. Watch for slowdowns on I-4 westbound near Fairbanks Avenue. Road construction will have the right lane closed there from Fairbanks to Minnesota Avenue. And watch for a crash on I-4 eastbound at Fairbanks on the exit ramp. If you do see traffic problems, call the Safe Touch Security Traffic Tip Line, pound 250, keyword Orlando Traffic. From the Traffic Center, I'm Tyler McCombs.
Wait. Save big at Met.
We don't call it in, but wait, someone else will be waiting.
Oh, that's what that is?
Yeah, that was Leon Bright, but Wade is the spearhead. Leon's helping.
Selling your home, pay 1% commission and
I just told him, I think he's on hold right now.
Service for thousands less with Save on Your Home. Read the reviews on Facebook. Buying a home or new construction, it's free to
you. Yeah, I probably better just have him come in and call in.
They will. SaveOnYourHomes.com.
But my thing is, because you now you went to the point now you speak about this man's money. First of all, everybody knows that's something you don't do as an athlete. You don't speak about no man's money. That's an unwritten rule. That's in every sport.
Yeah.
And what y'all is doing, attacking this kid like this here, because he's a young kid, y'all attacking this kid like this here to force him to be lowballed. And he's been the only constant in our entire organization.
He ain't though. He ain't getting no.
His agent ain't gonna let him do it.
He ain't gonna do it.
You know what I'm saying? Well, I'm glad his agent has been in there to tell him, like, because he didn't, at first, man, at the beginning, he didn't want
to. His agent told him that he should take the 33. That first doctor. Listen to me, man. His agent told him he should take the 33. He said, when we come in, we're going to do it. But he said, no. That's it. No. No. He ain't taking none under 35.
At the end of the day, Emmett was dead wrong this week. Because Emmett, you had a 1993, and you became the highest paid running back in the NFL the same year you had that. They gave you a contract.
We can talk about that right now.
Like, that is crazy.
We can talk about that right now. 954-771-DOOR. 954-771.
He's still on the line, but he's not answering what I'm trying to, like, ask him if he's still there. Do you want me to drop him or keep him on?
That's why at Orlando Synergy Marketing, they give you personalized...
Let him stay, and when we come on, we'll talk about it. Say what's up to him. If he don't answer, then drop him. So this is the problem, right? For what? I just told you everybody got a puppy. Just told you that. And there ain't no different.
That's what I said earlier when you was talking about. I said that when you was talking about him. I said Emma's a puppy. Emma's getting paid. He's getting paid by Dallas. He has position. They got him. They talked about it the other day. He's an ambassador. He gets paid like two. I think it's like 2 point some million a year from Dallas. He was doing a speaking engagement for the Dallas Cowboys when he hated on the boy. This week, that was Wednesday? Did that?
Yeah, I seen that.
Like, dude, stop. Don't miss it. Tax time means a much
needed cash bonus for many people, but for business owners, they talking about trading back and getting cool.
It's on all kind of stuff. Everything.
And if I was Jack, I'd be happy. I'd be like, please trade me to the Dolphins and get to it. Go ahead. Because the Dolphins gonna do everything in their power to do.
Not just the Dolphins, man. San Diego, all the teams will take that.
Oh, absolutely.
A whole slew of them. About 15 teams will take that right now.
He called back. The line was busy as well.
Chicago will take it.
Tax refund up to $2,500. RC Hill Mitsubishi specializes in approving customers with...
Yep, that was him. He's on 800.
Scores. My goal this month is 100% credit approval. This month, my prices will not be beat. This sale...
That we on line one?
13 seconds.
We got two calls.
Man, he's gonna be on there a while too, talking about that thing.
No, we don't. We got. We just
get the thing short.
Yeah. But
go ahead. Do your what's the name, Tori?
Yeah, let's do the first two. Is fine. Turn up. Turn up.
Like on here?
No.
I didn't touch the bowling.
Yo, what's up, sir. Y'all? And we back.
Shout out to Southern Scissor Works in Ocala, the best barbershop in Florida. Thanks for sponsoring and tuning in. That's shout out to Southern Scissor Works in Ocala, Florida. And also, big ups to Restaurant of the Week. Our Restaurant of the Week this week is the Tavern in Rock Springs Ridge. They have a great dinner, cocktails, beer, sports bar, and also you can call them for private events. And that's at 407-814-7474. And that's the Tavern at Rock Springs Ridge. By the way, my favorite dish there is the salmon. You should try it. They make great salmon there as well.
Hey, when you say the four, you got to say the four.
I'm sorry, I'm not as country as a bowl of grits out of pot for Florida being cooked up.
Yo, what's up, yo? Hello?
Hello.
Hey, what's up, man? Who we speaking with?
This is Wade Rawlinson. You just talked with Leon, and I've been working with Leon on the game and so forth, and just following up to add a few comments. Having listened a little bit to Leon talking to you, just some of the thoughts that did go into trying to get the game going. I was a longtime high school coach as well as a college coach, and coached at DeLand Mainland. I was the head coach at Leon up in Tallahassee, and I was at Lincoln. When we were at Mainland, we won a state championship. Back when, I always wanted to coach in the game, and at that time, my career wasn't developed enough to be named as a coach. And then the game went away, and so we've been trying to bring it back, but a couple of things you brought up with Leon is the reason we went summer, as Leon pointed out, a lot of the good players are moving on at the mid-year of their senior year because they're trying to get to the college campus and compete during spring practice for playing time. And the other thing is that up in Georgia, they had a rising seniors game where not only was the game played, but they've kind of incorporated some educational things about recruiting, about social media, different things that we want to try to include with the game as well. Joe Burns played at Thomas County Central up there and then eventually played for the Bills, has put this game on. It's been a magnificent game. So, you know, just trying to couple a couple of things together with the game.
Oh, that's what's up, man. I don't know. I think it's just hard for me to see exactly without sitting down and actually seeing exactly what you guys have put together. It's kind of hard for me to see it getting played over the summer. You know, I think I need to sit down with you guys and actually see what exactly it is that you guys are planning to do and, you know, how it's going to be, you know, put together and everything.
Well, the original game was played in the summer as well when the Florida Citrus Bowl and Bill Buckhalter, the old Orlando Sentinel writer, used to pick a Super 24 for the state of Florida. And those were the first 24 players, and they had 33 on a roster back then. But it was a summer game, and it was between graduation and they're going off to college. And as mentioned, injury is a concern. You certainly don't want to see any player hurt, whether it's going off to college or going into his senior year. So that's why we've been trying to communicate through the coaches, because obviously if a coach is overly concerned, we don't want to put pressure on a kid to play in the game.
So basically you're putting this game together to live out your coaching dream of coaching a Florida All-Star team.
Well, I'm not going to coach in it. I'm just going to direct it, I guess, and give other coaches the opportunity. Plus, I just thought it was a great thing when we had it. We had so many great players that went on to play in the league that...
like me.
You know, and as you guys mentioned, there's a lot of players in Florida and Georgia both that are top flight prospects in a highly recruited area. And, you know, some of them are the recruiting envelope has moved up. Juniors and even sophomores are getting, you know, 15 offers.
Are you going to be biased and try to get a bunch of kids from D-Land?
No, well, I do have there's an excellent player at DeLand.
See what I mean? This is what I'm talking about. Do you consider him as one of the top players in the state?
Oh, he probably has about 10 offers. Yes, I do. I think he was at Deltona and then moved over there. But we're getting players. We got a receiver, Ja'Cory Brooks from Booker T. Washington down in the Miami area, and they won the state championship. The quarterback from Armwood, Ransom, is a good gracious. He's a big, strong left-handed kid that throws the ball unbelievable. We saw him play in the playoffs against Edgewater. Part of the player selection is also to represent all the areas of the state. So as we go through the process, you know, I wouldn't say our players are 1 through 38 in the rankings. Our players are trying to represent Tallahassee, Miami, Naples, Bradenton, Manatee, as well as our coaches.
So you're saying you're going to take the best player out of that area is what you're targeting? Is that fair to say?
Like on staff, Joey Wiles would be the head coach for Florida. He's from San Augustine, legendary, longtime coach. We've got Yoshi.
He ain't won nothing, though.
Head coach. Pardon me?
He ain't won nothing.
He won a state championship.
Won. And he's been there for 50 years.
I know this. There's plenty of coaches on the staff.
I'm just playing, man.
Won a state championship.
I'm just playing.
He's joking at you. But no, on a serious note, though, what I was saying is, like, are you targeting, though, the best player in each area, though?
Correct. And I've tried to select coaches from the areas to recognize those players.
That's what's up.
Like Charlie Tate from Winter Haven.
Okay.
Ed Farmer from Vanguard in Ocala. Curly Brown over at Merritt Island. Just a few of the coaches so far.
I'm excited about it, honestly. I mean, because like you said, I grew up on that game, the Florida Georgia game, so sure. I'm very excited about it. And I know that, you know, and like anything, you got to get, once you get it back out there again and then get that first run, and then it gets better as each layer, you know what I mean? It's, you know, because people get back more interested in it, that it's back going again. So I'm very excited about it, you know. I just hope that we make sure that we continue to get the best area talent and not become a favor thing, not become one of those things that I'm doing a favor for this coach and I'm going to put this kid in there versus I'm going to have the best kid in that area. You know what I'm saying?
I just same thing I just did.
And I think it's also going to be a good opportunity because the World Sports Alumni Association, which Brandon's a part of course, is going to be behind this as a partner. And then there's going to be a great event to showcase talent to our NFL agents. We're going to have college scouts there. We'll have a lot of media there, et cetera, et cetera. So it'll be a great game to showcase the talents of the kids, and I think it'll grow from there. So we got a lot of fans tuning in today that have been messaging us on Facebook saying that they're really excited about seeing the Florida Georgia game revive. And so I think you'll get a lot of good support, Coach.
All right, Coach, man. Thank you for calling in, but we got to get go.
All righty. Thank you. Thank you for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you. So, the Florida Georgia game is about to be out. We got another caller, man. Hold on, let's see who it is. Yo! Hello? Yo! Yo! So, let's move on, man.
Absolutely.
Because we gotta hit one topic that we haven't hit yet, and that's it's like these 2 hours be running by, man.
Running by so fast.
Man, we gotta talk about the NFL.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
And I should have started off with this because this is gonna be the longest topic. I should have started off with this, but you know the way the tides turned today. You know, my bad. But listen, Dak Prescott, Tom Brady, who else? Phillip Rivers, all these free agent quarterbacks, Jameis Winston, and all these free agent quarterbacks that's out there now, I personally feel like Dak is getting treated the worst out of everybody.
Everybody.
Now, one of the reasons is because he's on America's team. He get more press than all the other quarterbacks it is. Every day you look at
the media, they talk about Dallas Cowboys every day. So, you know, with that said, Dak gonna get a lot of conversation.
But right now, though, Dak is getting unwarranted. What's going on right now is unwarranted, because the thing is, Dak has been that constant for the Cowboys the last 4 years. Dak has not been going to jail. Dak ain't been getting arrested. Dak has been the one constant we know is going to show up every day at practice and going to perform to his best of his abilities on Sunday. And for now, all of a sudden, for them to be having, they gave all that guaranteed money to the running back who had been in trouble 3, 4, 5 times. Lawrence got his money. He been in trouble. He popped on urinalysis tests and everything, was suspended. Got all his money, the highest paid Dallas Cowboy ever. And all of a sudden, we trying to debate and find reasons not to pay Dak. Is that what we're doing in Dallas? We got guys like Emmitt Smith, who's doing something that's not supposed to be done in no sports, professional sports, is speaking on another man's money. And you getting on radio shows and talk shows saying Dak should take a discount if he want to do this, and the third. That's absurd. And at the end of the day, I'm holding the Cowboy fans accountable for all of this. And the reason why I'm holding y'all accountable is because you Cowboy fans have not come to Dak aid and let Jerry Jones know, who has a weekly radio show. Jerry's on the radio weekly, and you guys won't call in and call Jerry Jones out for the foolishness that him and his son, Stephen Jones, as well as Emmitt Smith is doing. Get this man his money. This man has done more than all these other guys out here that got all this money.
This is what I'm gonna say. I said it earlier, and I'm gonna say it again. Everybody has a puppet. Emmitt Smith is just that, a puppet.
Yes, we know. We know he's a puppet.
Why you think Thurman Thomas ain't with the Bills right now, doing the same thing Emmitt doing? Because Thurman Thomas was arguably just as good. He was, you know, right. He was a killer too.
Right.
But you can't make Thurman say something that he don't believe in.
Right.
You know what I mean? You can't have Thurman out there saying, oh, tell Dak he need to take a... That's who I should have had come in today. I should have called the homie and told him to come in today so we could talk about this. But you can't get him to do that.
Right.
You know what I mean? And Emmitt is a bona fide puppet. That's what he is. Use a puppet. And I'm finna say something.
I know what you're about to say.
But I caught myself.
Right. But again, Emmitt was a guy that held out, listeners, for you that don't know. Emmitt held out in 1993. He held out for 2 games, and then he became the highest paid running back in the NFL.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now he's the same guy years later telling another guy, don't hold out, come in, and take a discount for the team's sake. Something that you did not do yourself.
All right, so now that we done got everything out about that, hey, pay the man. You know what I mean? Money. Now that we done got everything out about that, let's talk about the GOAT.
Who's the GOAT?
Stop playing.
Who's the GOAT?
Stop playing.
Who's the GOAT?
Stop playing.
Who's the GOAT? Then you go with the foolishness.
This is how I know you used to get beat up. Now, this is what I know. This is what I know. Stop playing, man. Everybody know who the GOAT is.
No, we don't.
Joe Montana.
There the GOAT. The Joe, Smoking Joe.
He got an argument.
Joe Money.
He got an argument.
Tom Brady's a GOAT of this millennium.
Tom Brady, the GOAT of all time. The greatest of all time.
So what are we discussing? We discussing past or we discussing current? Presently, what are you doing?
It don't matter what we discuss.
No, because that's important. That's important. We got to be discussing what he's doing presently, because we can't talk about what he used to do. Presently, he's stinking up the gym. Or as we say, he's stinking up the field that he plays on. And as I told you before, he would not be a Patriot. Belichick would not, and I repeat, and I told you this here. I told you this over a month ago. You didn't want to believe me. Now it's coming to fruition. He would not be a Patriot. He would not get no money from that organization.
You said they weren't offering more than 10, and they offered him
30. They did. That was the disrespect to let him know we don't think you're worth nothing.
They offered him 30.
Okay.
Offered him 30. What are you talking about?
They offered him 30, and all of a sudden he don't want 30. They didn't offer him no 30.
It ain't about.
That's hearsay.
See, this is what you know.
If he really had 30, he'd have signed.
It ain't about Tom. It ain't about the money for Tom.
But don't worry, hold your thoughts, son.
What is it about?
Hold your thoughts. Hold your thoughts. We're going to be back in a second, man. We got to let the people pay the bills. We'll be back in a second.
Stop.
No, don't try to. Selling your home, pay 1% commission instead of 6% or more. Get the same service for thousands less. Save on your home. Read the reviews on Facebook. New construction, it's free to use Save on Your Homes, and they rebate 1% of the purchase price towards closing costs. Go to saveonyourhomes.com. Try Save on Your Homes once, and they'll be your agents for life. 407-564-1077.
That's 407-564-1077.
Save on
Your
Homes.com. Empire Network Realty.
Need social media help? Marketing determines the success or failure of every business. That's why at Orlando Synergy Marketing, they give you personalized service and structure to ensure the success of your business. Orlando Synergy are the social media experts at utilizing Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and incorporating e-blasts and social media optimization to dramatically boost your business. You can replace money, but you can't give back your time. Call 407-782-4978 or visit OrlandoSynergy.com.
Come to Wings in Apopka and taste the best chicken wings you've ever had. Wings gets all their chicken wings from local farms. Flavors like jerk, garlic parmesan, Hawaiian barbecue, or the owner NFL Pro Bowler Brandon Merriweather's famous vodka wings. And Wings is the official wing spot of the Merriweather Dixon Show, located at 452 North Park Avenue, Apopka. Open Tuesday through Sunday. And like a lot of people, get wings.
You can't run out of the hole like that.
For a new restaurant, the Tavern at Rock Springs Ridge is the hidden gem of Apopka, where all the locals know to go for great food and fantastic atmosphere. The tavern has 78 locations all around with a full bar, as well as celebrity owner, NFL star Brandon Merriweather, seen daily in house. The tavern also has a private banquet room with full AV capability and was voted best of Apopka by the Chamber of Commerce. The Tavern at Rock Springs Ridge. Call 407-814-7477.
PJ Walker, man. Y'all better get up on him, man. The quarterback, Patrick Mahomes at SFL. Y'all better get up on him.
I'm not a big talker. I am a big doer.
But
sometimes the only way to solve the problem is to get on the horn and figure it out. So the only people I like talking to,
knowledgeable product expert, you go
ready
for the
answers to my toughest questions. Colin Granger is the one conversation I don't mind having. From machining and motor parts to valves and vacuum pumps. When it comes to solving my problems, Granger's got my back. Call, click Granger.com, or stop by to see for yourself.
Exclusions and more fees apply. See store or Lowe's.com for details and licensing.
Terrible. What'd you think? The 13 at Bell. This report is sponsored by Taco Bell. I'm Fox 35. Blue. Say blue. Say blue. Blue. That's silver, right? Don't try that. Don't try to be like that. Silver red. Say blue. 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 Say blue.
location near you.
Why you took what's the name and didn't take me, bro? I'm mad as hell. Is
that what you talking about?
Papa Lola Wayne. You can come when you want to go.
Pinklin Thomas.
Now, back to the WSA, WorldSportsAlumni.com Hour, with the Brandon Merriweather Show, with his realist co-host, Tori Lewis.
What is really? SaveOnDirtyHoles.com. On fire.
Yo, shout out to SSI Roofing, Impact Windows and Doors, 30 years experience, licensed and insured, SSIConstruction.com. Wings in a Apopka, open Tuesday through Saturday. The best wings in Florida. Check out one of the best lunch specials in Orlando. 10 wings and a fry for $7.50. book us for your next event, book us for your next event and appearance. Message us on Facebook, the Brandon Merriweather Show. You could get me and Tori Lewis for a little bit of nothing.
That was too cute.
Hey man, cute. Y'all hit me up on IG Merriweather31 of the Brandon Merriweather Show. Follow my Facebook, the Brandon Merriweather. Y'all hit me up. Alright. Oh, we got another one?
Yes, we do. We have the athleticjunctionevents.com who sell tickets to your they will sell tickets to your next event or sports event. That's athleticjunctionevents.com.
Alrighty then.
Yes, sir.
So back to what we was talking about. There go. Mr. Tom Brady. Hey, when you talk about Mr. Tom Brady, you say Mr.
Never.
You say Mr. when you're talking about him. Say Mr. Tom Brady, sir.
Never.
How are you?
Never.
That's how you better talk about
so
Tom.
So tell
Brady
us about Tom then. Tell us about Tom. What's going on with Tom?
Listen here. I called the homie the other day. You know what he told me?
And I'm sure he picked up on the first ring because nobody else called him.
Let me tell you what he told me.
What did he tell you?
Hey, you want to know? You want to know?
I don't want to know.
You want to know?
I know he had time on his hands, though.
You want to know?
No, I don't. Hey, I know he had time. He picked up on the first ring because nobody else called him.
Hey, everybody called
him. Nobody called.
What you talking about? Everybody called.
Nobody called.
Boy, they talking about throwing away their whole team for Tom Brady.
Who?
Everybody.
A fool.
Everybody.
A fool.
Everybody.
A fool.
Listen. A lot of people think
Tom's I take gonna... Trevor Lawrence over Tom Brady right now.
He young. I would too.
That had never played in the NFL. I take him right now.
He young. I would too. I take Dak over Tom right now. What you mean? They're young.
Okay. Okay.
They're young. Tom got 2 years max. Max. Okay. Listen,
I take Andy Dalton over Tom right now.
You lost your.
He's gonna be the starter in New England. Andy Dalton.
Yeah, and they gonna go 10-6.
And.
10-6.
Okay.
No, cool. won't make the playoff.
No, you lying.
10-6.
They're gonna win
the
that
playoff.
Division again.
No, they not.
But who's not gonna be
there? If they don't have Tom Brady, they will not win the division.
Stop.
You heard it here first, fellas. I'm telling
you. So what you heard about Tom, Brandon?
Listen, a lot of people thinking Tom going to
San Diego
or Oakland.
Tennessee.
I think the Patriots finna make a splash in free agency. I think they gonna trade something to get Diggs. Mark my words. Mm-mm. Because one thing I do know,
Diggs' contract is not friendly enough for them to want to go get him. I'm going to tell you that right now.
What are you talking
Diggs
about?
Diggs, just the way his contract is.
He only
is,
got one more year on his contract.
No, he does not. He just signed a $70 million contract.
Yeah, 3 years ago. He got one more year on his contract.
I just read that. Next, it's a $15 million hit. New England's not going to spend that.
Yeah, they will. They got the salary cap to do it.
That means Brady coming back for the free?
No, Brady going to come back for the 30.
No, 30
mean.
No.
What do you mean? He's coming back for the 30. What are you talking about, man?
No.
What's his name? Diggs?
Trayvon. I mean, not Trayvon, but Stephon Diggs. Stephon Diggs. Stephon. No. F.
Oh, okay. Steph.
Stephon Diggs. There it is right there. Oop, got my eye at you.
What I'm trying to tell you is he got one more year on his contract, right?
Like I just said, five-year deal. Look at that. Next year he's due. 15 gonna be next year. I just read
that.
No,
that's signing bonus right there. That's
no, but he's due $15 million this upcoming season on it. I just read it last night.
How many years he got left though? Because I know he did this.
He signed it in 18. He was previously set to be unrestricted free agent. Fall 18. He just signed that. That's a fresh deal.
Oh, that was 3 years ago. So that means he did it.
He signed it in 17.
Right.
It ain't up to 22.
That was 3 years ago. So the bulk of the contract is gone.
He's due 15 next season.
Listen, mark my words.
No.
Mark my words.
No. I'm not marking your words.
The Patriots gonna go get another receiver. Nah, it might not be Stealth.
It might go get your cousin, Mike.
It might. But I doubt it.
I mean, he just apologized to him. I mean, he's around here wearing a New England jersey.
Yeah, but you let the boss man. He in his feelings now. You know what I mean, Mr. Kraft in his feelings now. He in his feelings now. You can't take shots at the boss man and expect to be back. You know what I mean? So it is what it is.
The fight tonight.
I don't care about that fight, man.
We need to pick somebody, though, before you... I mean, honestly, like Brady, but we need to pick somebody on this fight tonight.
I like Wilder. I already picked him. Long time ago.
Knockout?
Yeah.
What round?
Fifth
round knockout tonight. Okay. Yeah, remember that now. Brandon said fifth round. I said the seventh round would be a knockout.
I would have said the seventh, too, but I wanted to give him
seventh round.
I feel like the way Buddy talking about, if Buddy do what he said he gonna do, I say it's the fifth. He said he planning on knocking Wilder out. He said he not leaving it up to the judges no more. He said he coming in there, he gonna stand in the paint and give him everything he wants.
I don't believe him. He's lying.
I don't believe him either. I don't believe him either. But like I said, if he planning on doing that, he gonna get his head ripped off.
Absolutely.
I mean, you can't change up what you do, man. And try to do what somebody else do who been doing this forever.
Right.
Like that's asking to be knocked out.
Well, who do you think won the last fight?
These nuts.
Wilder won the fight last time.
Wilder won the fight.
It was the count. Well, they messed the count up. They timed it. He stood over for a minute before he started counting.
Come on, buddy. Listen, that was the best thing that ever could have happened to Wilder.
More money?
Yep.
Because if you win that night with the TKO, then who you going to fight? You ain't got money.
Because
nobody wants to see Joshua.
Nobody
wants to see Joshua anyway. That's not a big fight.
I mean,
ever since Joshua lost to Ruiz, it kind of took
But Joshua lost to Ruiz because he was hurt. He shouldn't have even had that fight, man. He should have just, come on, buddy. He shouldn't even have that fight, man. So I want to see that. That's who I want to see fight. Know what I mean?
Right.
Like if you could get Joshua and Wilder in the fight, I would go see that. Somebody would have to take me to Vegas, man.
I think Joshua would have to step it up in order to compete with Wilder. I think Wilder is just so powerful.
Man, but Joshua might be the only person who could beat Wilder. You know what I mean?
You think he's a better boxer? Better boxer than Fury? So that first fight they fought, I was watching with Mark Lanton, who's in a Boxing Hall of Fame, and Roy Jones Jr. is a former partner, and he said that he thought Fury won the fight, and the Fury outboxed Wilder.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're going, listen, but you can't get knocked down twice and say you won. You know what I mean?
I agree. Like I think the rules of boxing scoring is messed up. I said, how can a guy knock the other guy down two times and like call that a draw?
Because he outboxed him, man.
Yeah,
the
point system is weird. I think the knockout should be worth, a knockdown should be worth a lot more.
Oh, I agree. I 100% agree with that. I think if you get knocked down, they need to take 5 points away from you.
Yeah, something big, something monumental.
Because you get knocked down, you only get knocked off 1 point. Then what does that say?
Wilder in an interview recently said that, because the interviewer was saying that, what if you're losing a fight and you're losing like five rounds? He says, I don't care. I know I'm going to knock the guy out.
Hey, listen. Pink, you my dog, and I know you listen to Pink. But if you telling me you got to be a real class athlete and you look like Fury and your body shaped like Fury,
there's a problem.
We got a problem.
Hey, we got to go some AAU basketball games here, too.
Yeah, that's fine. But you got a problem. We got a problem.
Can I say that so quick?
If you think Fury is a world-class athlete, you lost your mind. And what I'm telling you, you think Fury is a world-class athlete?
No.
But you see his body? Oh, my God.
No.
Hey, Dr. Mike, you need to call Fury, man.
For real.
Boy, that boy body is so good.
Dr. Miami, I'm sending one down there to you. His name Tyson Fury. I'm sending him down there to you. Scope that boy body.
All right, man. So listen, we got to go, man. We got to go.
Yes, sir.
You know, it was fun today. You know what I mean? I found out that Tory used to get beat up. You know what I mean?
You know, I found out today my dog was in the Marines. You know what I mean?
God.
I ain't know all this.
You
know,
I think we need to set up a Tory Brandon boxing matchup, a little sparring contest.
Tory don't want none of these problems.
Listen, for charity, I do it. I knock
out Tory, step it up.
For charity, I do it.
Listen,
and the boxing ring. I want the boxing ring set up right there in the Apopka, because I want to knock him out right there in front of all his family.
You see, Brandon's fists are kind of small, but he said they hurt.
Like I said, I would do it for charity boxing event, and I want it set up in the Apopka. That's my word.
Oh, boy.
Tuscaloosa, Roll Tide.
After I knock him out, I'm driving down Rio Grande. All right, y'all. We appreciate you,
love y'all,
but
man.
We out there. I was
fighting for charity. All proceeds.
Bro, you
want to
get knocked out for charity?
Bro, that won't happen. I promise you that won't happen.
No, you wouldn't get knocked out for charity.
I promise you that won't happen. I'm telling you, bro.
You tell him you wouldn't get knocked out for charity.
Bro, I don't. I won't.